Buffalo soldier in the heart of America, stolen from Africa, brought to America, fighting an arrival, fighting for survival. I mean it when I analyze the stench. To me, it makes a lot of sense. Of the dreadlock rasta, why the Buffalo soldier, and he was taken from Africa, brought to America, fighting an arrival, fighting for survival. Said he was a Buffalo soldier, dreadlock rasta. Buffalo soldier in the heart of America. If you knew your history, then you would know where you're coming from. Then you wouldn't have to ask me who the heck you would think I am. And just a Buffalo soldier in the heart of America, stolen from Africa, brought to America. Said he was fighting on the rival, fighting for survival. Said he was a Buffalo soldier in the war for America. Said he, why yo yo, why yo yo yo, why yo 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 yo, why yo yo, why yo yo yo, why yo 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 yo. Buffalo soldier, tried into the land. Said he wanna run and make him wanna hang. Tried into the land. Yeah, yeah. Said he was a Buffalo soldier in the war for America. Buffalo soldier, dreadlock rasta. Fighting an arrival, fighting for survival. Driven from the mainland to the heart of the Caribbean. Singing, why yo yo, why yo yo yo, why yo 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 yo, why yo yo, why yo yo yo, why yo 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 yo. Riding through San Juan in the arms of America, riding to Jamaica, a Buffalo soldier, fighting an arrival, fighting for survival. Buffalo soldier, dreadlock rasta. Why yo yo, why yo yo yo, why yo 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 yo, why yo yo.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. It is hey Alexa, pause music. Thank you very much. It is officially Wind Down Wednesday. So I'm about to go crack me open some wine, but I'm a little sad today. But I won't let it blow my mood for the very reason I go to open up my laptop, my MacBook, my heart and soul, where this laptop was my plan to make it out. And unfortunately, I think he's come to his death this morning. I woke up and I left it in the charge overnight, fell asleep, and he was overheated. He was overheated, unfortunately, and he's not turning on. And it's a little devastating. It's a little devastating because as you guys can hear, he doesn't want to turn on right now, and I have to deal with that bullshit a little bit later. But listen, no laptop, the show goes on. The show goes on because all I need is this iPhone in front of me, and I'm going to make this thing shake. But to get to better news, $18,000 Bitcoin, right? I see some people speculating, saying, hey, we're moving in the right direction. I don't know. I personally don't know. I wouldn't get too excited necessarily, right? This could be another trap, I would say. This very well could be another trap. So stay vigilant, stay cautious. We still are in the depths of a deep, deep bear market. We could go up and we could go back down a little bit, but I do think 18,000 is probably a little bit more where we belonged and where we were before. So let's just continue to monitor it. This is not financial advice, but don't do anything irrational right now. But it's great to see things trending a little upwards from where we were, at least. The future of login, great thread by Drea, absolutely blew up. 817 likes, 192 retweets. Sign up with Ethereum is the future of login, right? Everywhere, in my opinion, will have signing with Ethereum. Logging in to pay your apartment complex bill, when you log into Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, WhatsApp, TikTok, whatever. It only makes sense. We're going to live in a world dominated by wallets. We're going to live in a world dominated by Web3. It makes sense. Now, signing up for Ethereum, you guys read the thread, is completely different than Connect Wallet. Two entirely different things there. But great thread. Shout out to you, Jared, for that thread blowing up. And guys, let's try to get it to 1,000 likes. Let's try to get to 1,000 likes if we can. Cool. Let's keep moving forward. 68 five digits just got swept by one person. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, the digits aren't going nowhere. They're not going nowhere. It doesn't matter if you like it, you hate it. They're not going anywhere. Their liquidity will forever be in the digits, in my personal opinion. This is not financial advice, by the way. But as easy as it is to just sweep 68 five digits, it's easy to sweep four digits, it's easy to sweep three digits. That's where the liquidity is, to get in and out of positions. And DGens love liquidity, right? I would hope so. I love liquidity. So shout out to the digits. 68 just got swept. And I thought this video was super hilarious. Nobody, ENSMFers, after sniping the .eth domain of a local orphanage. And that was just so hilarious to me because I know somebody who actually went and registered orphanages' names, right? So it shows how deep we're willing to go in this game of sniping something that is still available, instead of sometimes maybe just going and getting something on the secondary market. But it is what it is. And last but not least, y'all, I was about to start sending out, I know I got a couple of DMs, I saw to send out a couple of these ENS updates, speaker collectibles. Unfortunately, my laptop is not working right now, so that's going to have to get postponed. I used to do it on my phone and on my laptop at the same time. I'm just sending them out as the DMs are coming in. But we'll figure that out. But if you have spoke on ENS updates and I haven't already sent you one, which is a lot of people, it's hard for me to keep track. I sent some people too. Just the DMs I'm getting, I sent Stephen Miller too. So Stephen, you're a special guy. You got two of them things, man. But it is what it is. So that's enough for me for the day. I am going to try to fix this while also hosting at the same time because I need my laptop. It's super vital. But that being said, I'm going to go ahead and pass the mic over to the man, the myth, the legend, the one and only Orin One. The stage is yours, brother.
Hey, GM Kev, GM everybody. Yeah, I hate that when it happens, when your laptop crashes. Because I've always, of course, I switched to Mac a couple years ago, the MacBook. But before that, I still bought really expensive ones. So I used to get 5-6 years out of a computer, you know? And yeah, and it really is bothersome when they go bad. So especially if they have some private keys on them and you lose 10, 20 grand of Bitcoin. But anyway, we won't talk about that. Yeah, it's not going to complain about the snow because after yesterday complaining, I think it snowed another 6-8 inches. So I'm not making any better, but I appreciate that Caribbean vibe. I was able to project myself laying on a beach where I should be, but it's bear market. So it's time to eat oatmeal and work out and grind. So the beach can come later, but rather be doing it on a beach, but that's for next. That's for the bull market talk. But yeah, enjoyed that thread signing with Ethereum. I think that is huge. I think that's almost like, why isn't everyone using it at this point, right? I think it's so simple, so good. They call it Siwi, it's kind of cute, but no, I'm really excited about that. I think that's going to help definitely launch us to the next thing. I swept a couple hundred keycap 5 digits. Okay. Now maybe, no one really wants the 5 digits. Really, no one wants the keycaps, but I'm telling you, these things were freaking grails. I'm talking like 888-880-77. I mean, dude, grails. And knowing they were sitting there to be registered. So I don't know. To me, I know the 5-digit hasn't got the love, and I know we need a lot of adoption before they're going to be worth something. But to me, owning 1,000 5-digits isn't too much. I am going to be sweeping more 5-digits. But then I thought, I'll just check the keycap 5-digits. And I literally, over the last 2 days, swept probably close to 200 of them. Freaking grails, every one of them. Every one of them. Like, all grails. And So yeah, there's stuff out there, there's little niches here and there, and I don't believe they'll be worth anything till literally the masses come, but I'm happy to sit on them for 5 or 10 years, and I don't believe that I'll sell any of those for less than an ETH, and maybe some a lot more. I mean, so anyway, so that's it. I'm in grind mode. I think I told everyone Monday I started in grind mode, so I always work a lot, but not always like disciplined, having to set a schedule and just do stuff I don't like. So, didn't want to do, sit at my desk and work. I haven't done that for a while. It's a little bit of a transition for me, but this is the time when you do that. This is the time when that'll pay off. I had a nice year last year, had a lot of fun, and was, during the last bull market, and now I'm going to have 10 times more fun in the next one. So grinding, and hope everyone else doing the same. I know Master's doing his grind. Oh, by the way, congratulations to Argentina. Really impressed with those guys, really impressed by Messi. And that was cool. And there's another game today. So yeah, shout out to everyone. Had a great time on the Shark Tank yesterday. It's a lot of difference when you're sitting there as a shark and you're pulling stuff up and have to evaluate. But had a really nice time with Steven. They were kicking butt and taking names. That thing gets better every time. It's the first time I was on there evaluating, picked up a couple things, made a few offers, and got rejected. And anyway, it was nice to be on there. I think that's a thing for the community. And then shout out to them for having me. Had a real nice time. Anyway, I'm in full. This reminds me of when we had we took our internet company public. I literally met my personal trainer at 5 a.m. and I worked till 11 or 12 at night. I mean, we did that for a few years, and it was crazy results, I was a lot younger back then, but it feels fun to be excited, even in a bear market. And the reason I'm excited is because doing a little bit of building, doing a little bit of dollar cost averaging, doing just knowing that it's going to pay off. Maybe the last time I ever have to do this, if I want to. I'll always work and stuff, but like I say, I prefer to do it from back of a yacht or a beach. But right now, I'm in full bear market grind. I'm gonna lose 40, 50 pounds. I'm gonna get in good shape, and I'm just not spending any money and just doing the damn thing, as Punks always says. So, yeah, looking forward to hearing what everyone in the community has to say. Looking forward to getting some insight. And then I think it's time we all need to do this. And once you dig in your heels, once you set your mind 5 years down the road, and you set your mind that, hey, this isn't the time to have fun. This is the time to work. I think it changes your perspective and you start to enjoy it. So anyway, yeah, looking forward to today's discussion. Looking forward to Wine Wednesday, even though I don't drink.
Yes, sir. Ron, when we're on the island, I know you don't drink. I know you don't drink, but we got to take a toast on the island. Nothing big, nothing crazy, just one little toast to the journey that led us to that moment. But yeah, always great having you on, Ron. Shark Tank yesterday was a great episode. And Ron is a shark, y'all. Ron is not, let me not say shark. Ron is a whale on that Shark Tank, right? I think you added a great element to the show, right? I really did enjoy listening to it. The name, the one that stuck out with me, one, I think Lake House was a great deal. But Shooter.eth, man, I think Shooter.eth is a great name in a lot of different ways. That one really stuck out to me when he pitched it. For one, there's if you love guns, if you like guns, I think that's a phenomenal name. But two, like the gaming, if we're bringing gaming into Web3. So great, great stuff. Shout out to Steven and the crew, man. That's literally one of my favorite shows. So cool. You guys definitely need to bring Ron back on, though. For sure. I'll keep it moving right along here. Let's go over to the veteran, the man who makes it happen, the one and only Hall of Famer, Master.eth. The stage is yours, brother.
Hey, good morning, guys. Yes, Kevin, I agree with you guys 100%. Shooter is a great name. Maybe not only for gun, for weapon, but also maybe, you know, playing basketball. You know, the shooting guard, right? The shooter, you know. Maybe I'm not very familiar with English, but that's what it means to me. And everything has its own, you know, age and its duration and the period you have to wait. You know, the dot-com guys, back to 1990s, when they really registered that for use for making a website to instead of having an IP address, and then that they will really have some, you know, a URL, you know, at the very beginning. So yeah, when people just invest in the very early stage, they didn't realize it can be a big fortune when, you know, 30 years later they were going to sell it. And I think it's since Y2K and 2005 something that the massive registration started and the lots of the names got sold for very high prices. So yeah, everything needs to, you know, we need to undergo its own you know, with a circle or it's a round of the time, as always. So same for ETH. And I think, you know, if you check my Twitter, my pinned Twitter published by December 2019, which was exactly 3 years ago. And that was actually 1 month after I participated in the short domain auction during the same year. I think 1 month earlier, which was October to November, and I spent a lot of money and acquired lots of the grails. At that point of time, I didn't know whether or not this will be a very successful or not, you know, investment, because nothing is guaranteed yet. For crypto, for Ethereum, we didn't know. And in case Ethereum is killed by other technologies and these just like, you know, equipment in one game, and it will be useless. But yeah, we kind of proving the whole way, and it seems like we are on the winning team. And yeah, I think everything needs to undergo the whole process. You guys have been with the community. Most of you, I mean, has been here since this April, this March. Once, you know, we have a 999 and 10K club and more people are participating in this community and understand this is a great thing. But, you know, more people like me, you know, we've been here for more than like 3 or 4, even 5 years. So yeah, at the early phase, guys, you know, we are not very happy. We are not very confident. We are not very convincing because we didn't really 100% so sure that this is the right thing. This is the exact team, you know, the winning team that we are staying at. But it is more and more the right thing to do. You know, the right teammates, you know, the conversation and proving, we say the wrong proving, right? So it proves that we are not wrong. You know, we need to keep doing that to make sure we are always on the right track. And also, my pin, I mean, I just mentioned my pinned Twitter published by 3 years exact 3 years ago about ENS. And, you know, another thing just also happened by December 2019, which was the very early, you know, whistleblower of COVID. A doctor named Li Wenliang in Wuhan, and he found out that there was some very weird or new, you know, patients, and they look like catching some of the virus. But and he published on the BBS telling people be careful and wear masks at public. And then, you know, he was arrested by the local authorities. You think he is doing something not good to the local government. And they kind of, you know, want him to, I think they arrest him for like 7 or 10 days, and then they release him. Then the doctor got back to hospital to work, and then the massive, you know, COVID spread started. And the government acknowledged that, you know, since January 2020, which was 1 month later. And yeah, you guys all know at the very beginning, the first year of COVID is horrible. You know, people are dying. Lots of people are dying for getting COVID. And unfortunately, by February, you know, 2020, 2 months after the whistleblower blew the whistle. And unfortunately, Dr. Li Wenliang also, you know, caught COVID. And unfortunately, he passed away by that February of 2020, which was kind of almost three years ago. And after he passed away, you know, someone just created a hate on Ethereum, on EtherScan. So that's created, I think it's a contract that published a lot of the vivid, you know, information to commemorate his brave and as well as a condemn to the local government. I think that's something very cool. And I kind of learned from that, you know, EtherScan hate and the content. And I think that's very cool because no one can remove it. Even China government can be very concerned about someone, you know, saying something and even putting a condemn to them. But they got nothing to do with it because it's on the chain. It's on the Ethereum. It's anti-censorship. You guys cannot just remove it. I think it's so cool. That's why and at that point of time, I truly believe that's why blockchain was built at first place. We didn't, you know, blockchain is not meant to making people rich by, you know, flipping coins. That's not the purpose. That's not the spirit. You know, this is the spirit of why we need blockchain, why, you know, blockchain is so attractive and more people are getting on board to this. So that, you know, right now it's 3 years after whistleblower showed up. And I think it's also a moment for, you know, a project that, you know, organized and run by me, you know, who is the name of Red Letter. I mean, a red letter means it's a special day, it's a calendar day, and it's, you know, it's everything, you know, precious for us to mint, you know, in our moment. Because, you know, not everyone have the knowledge to, you know, create that contract, such as for the whistleblower, so, you know, commemorate. It's not as easy as like a 1, 2, 3. It's not simply a UI something. So that Red Letter's, you know, purpose or its mission is just to facilitate everyone to create his or her, you know, commemorable or his or her precious moment on chain. And then they can upload all their feelings, and we help them to create NFT or either a soulbound token, SBT. And then along with the picture itself, it contains the content of whatever, you know, messages he has, as long as well as the block ID, exact block ID, which, you know, where this message located at, something like that. So I believe it's 3 years, and we've been thinking a lot, and we've been doing a lot. I've been holding the grails of the ENS names for a long while. But at the meantime, we started. We didn't do nothing. You know, we kind of started moving, and from the maybe the ENS fans or investors, and right now we're moving to a builder. So that yes, I think that's something like an appetizer to share in this space, because, you know, we are really working very busy and hard recently, trying and targeting to make a Christmas launch. Because you guys know Red Letter's purpose is for all you guys to mint your precious moment on chain, so that you can type in something, you know, invite somebody, for example, marriage, you create something and you send, you write something and send to a party B to someone. And if he or she says yes, you need to approve the contract, say, okay, there's a SBT created for both of you to, you know, celebrate your marriage. It's something like that. It also works for if you, you have something personal, you just share it. It's just like you share on Facebook or Twitter, you upload what do you think and what's the deal. Like you can do a promotion, you can do a graduation. And you can also create your own, you know, NFT collection because of that. Because we believe that makes sense. You can also, you know, invite people to call a get together for some weekend. You can, like Donald Trump can call for a, you know, a parade in somewhere in New York. Yeah, everything, you know, on chain, as long as you can imagine. So this is just facilitating people to create such an Ethereum record that if you guys don't know how to and maybe uploading picture, you know, it looks a little complicated, then yeah, just use these two to do that. And that's kind of the whole picture of our program and right now, you know, of our project. And right now, maybe the Christmas launch, we want to give everyone an opportunity to send Christmas cards. That's why we are shooting to, we are aiming to launch the Christmas, you know, greeting cards to everyone so that you can use our platform to write to the, to your beloved ones, you know, to write either, either the hash address or their Ethereum address as a send to. And then you write the content, say, you can say Merry Christmas. You can say, you know, I really like your work and I'm so glad. Just all the information will show up on NFT. And it's just like sending a gift card using the public way. This will be the first, you know, product. This will be the first feature of functions for Red Letter to start. And then we will collect the, you know, the feedback from the community. And then we will launch the rest, like marriage, like graduation, promotion, you know, get together. Or you can launch an event and sell tickets, just like Eventbrite does in our platform. But everything is just on-chain, and we are using redletter.eth as an entrance way. So, yeah, this is something we are working on. Kev, he's a very, very close friend of us, and he's a very close friend to everyone who has a passion on ENS. So, any updates? Because it can be happening very soon. Before Christmas, you can count on it. Is that right now we have less than 2 weeks to announce the rest. So, yeah, Kev Space will be the first stop for us to share the progress regarding the next moves of Red Letter. And at the meantime, I already shared a couple of times that Red Letter will provide the redletter.e subdomain claim will start from the four characters or above. So which means if you come early, you know, you can get, you can probably get 9999 or coin or game or your name, first name, last name. You know, each account can at max mint one, you know, a red letter subdomain name. So that's how it works. You can send gift cards to as much people as you want, but you have to take the you know, the gas fee at your own cost. And we also support Polygon if you are very sensitive to the Ethereum main network's gas. So that's something I'm very proudly sharing to the community. And maybe tomorrow I'll share something additional if you know, our UI and our QA test has a great progress. But thanks much, guys. You know, I've been with this space for a very long time. I really feel the very strong power, you know, sharing between among the whole community. And I'm so glad because you guys know I'm not an English speaking guy. You know, English is not my native language, but I feel I'm talking to my family members every single day. That kind of feeling, you know, I didn't get a lot from maybe my day job or some of my close friends I meet every day. So that's something very warm in this winter time. I think maybe that's why Christmas is you know, December. Yeah, so happy to see you guys and look forward to the next days, you know, space during which we might be able to share a bit more. Thanks much, guys. Have a great day.
Yes, sir. Let's give some round of applause for Red Letter that is going to be releasing very soon by Master, something he's been talking about for quite some time. So I'm happy to see that you're going into the stage where releasing kind of the first version of it. And of course, it will continue to improve over time. So, you know, ENS Updates community, we're going to support your project. We're going to support it the best we can. Very excited about that and very excited to use the platform. Shout out to Master for being consistent and building, right? Building. We're in this thing. And this is why I'm so excited about ENS over the course of the next 12 to 36 months. I think we're in the stage of building right now. I think a lot of people are building a lot of cool and interesting things and experimenting with a lot of different things right now. And it goes from speculation to actually building more utility on top of a utility-driven asset. So from there is where we begin to see true adoption, when people are beginning to use these things on a day-to-day basis and begin to live life as if they cannot use these things, right? That's the type of tech we need to build if we want to see mass adoption. But with that being said, I also have a word from our sponsor, VPN, .eth.limo. Are you feeling tired and vulnerable and exposed online? Do you worry about your personal data being tracked and collected without your consent? With VPN.eth.limo, you can take control of your online privacy and security. Our easy-to-use website allows you to compare the best VPN providers and features so you can choose the right one for you. A VPN will protect your location, hide your IP address, and encrypt your internet traffic, ensuring that your personal data stays private. Don't wait any longer to take back your online security. Visit vpn.eth.limo now and sign up for a VPN today. Protect yourself and your loved ones from the prying eyes of hackers and cyber criminals. Sign up now and enjoy the peace of mind that comes with a secure and private internet connection. Cool. That being said, I'm going to pass the mic right over to our guy, the host of the ENS Friday Night Happy Hour, the sixth man of the year, the one and only NFT Versus. Stage is yours, brother.
GM, what's up, Kev? 5159, appreciate you as always, man. thank you for hosting the space. Thank you for just continuing to stay consistent out here, man. You know, I think sometimes we take it lightly, and I say that every day because it takes effort to do that. So, you know, the least I can say is I appreciate you doing that every single day. It may sound repetitive to a lot of people, but you have to acknowledge that and respect that. So that's why I always say that. Shout out to Ron, RM1, always being consistent and being in here. Master.eth, always being consistent and being in here. You know, as this space continues to evolve, you know, I'll say this because I've said it before. You never know who's going to leave. You never know who's going to stay. So make sure you make the connections in here, too. You know, while you're going on this journey, this 10,000 mile death march, as Ron would say, man, can get frustrating at times. So you need to have some individuals in here that you can reach out to and connect with. So I think that that's always a good thing. I know that I could reach out to Ron at any point in time, and you know, he'll always respond back. Master, he'll always respond back. 515. Not a lot of people in the community will always respond back. 00 Steven, everybody, right? But that's how you build those connections, right? And you never know when something may come up in their life and they may have to step away. You just never know. So I think it's important to build those connections. So shout out to 1261 Mafico, see Captain America in here, 00 Steven, my guy Flawson. We do have a space today. We have the emoji space. Maybe, I don't know if Flawson wants to come up and talk a little bit about it, but the guest tonight in the space at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time is the founder of Penelope's, you know, so I think a lot of you guys have heard of Penelope Country Club. They're going to be talking emojis tonight. So it's going to be nice to hear kind of, you know, the Penelope's founder, you know, the perspective on emojis. So, you know, he accepted the invite. So, you know, tune in tonight. Let's hear what, you know, what he has to say about emojis and everything. I saw Flossin come up, but two things I want to touch on really quick. Number one is the shooter.eth. So let me just give you real quick of my thoughts about shooter.eth. We've talked about the different ways you can utilize it, but here's my Web3 way of utilizing shooter. Master talked about it just a little bit. He said, the reference to basketball, right? I'll talk about basketball because I played basketball, you know, but one of the things that I reference it to is also is to basketball. Being a great shooter, is something that it takes an amazing skill set and practice. And I think a lot of us in here know who's the greatest shooter to ever live right now, and playing a game of basketball, and that is Steph Curry. Right. So my Web3 thought process behind using shooter would be, what if Under Armour, which is who Steph Curry is signed to, sponsored by, what if Under Armour wanted to secure shooter.eth? What if they wanted to build their digital virtual world around all of their sponsored athletes? What if they wanted to build a place in that particular metaverse or that digital world designed for Steph Curry? Because there will not be another shooter probably as great as he is in his art. So what if they built a place inside that metaverse and they called it shooter.eth? And then you could go in and you could actually play against or shoot against Steph Curry, you know, virtually using Oculus goggles or whatever you want to do. Imagine Under Armour building that feature for all of their sponsor athletes, where you could interact with them and maybe play against them or shoot against them or throw a football or hit a baseball. And it's just like that competitive right there in that virtual world. That's where I see shooter.eth going, because there's no person who should own shooter.eth to me more than Steph Curry or in the Under Armour team. So that's just my thought process, and I just want to share that with you guys. I think that would be pretty cool to build out something like that in a metaverse or a virtual world that Under Armour builds. So I think that would be cool. The second thing is, Ron talked about scooping up the keycap 5 digits. So I want to talk about that real quick, too, because I think what we got to understand is scarcity is scarcity. Rarity is rarity, no matter how you look at it. Right. So you got the normal digits out there. And we know that there's a certain amount of normal digits, from 3 digits to 5 digits. There are approximately 111,000 digits that are in that particular sequence. 5 digits. 3 digits all the way up to 5-digit normal numbers. We do know and we do realize that same scarcity is with keycap digits, right? So if you take that same scarcity plus add in the 2-digit keycaps, I think you get about 111,100 total keycap combinations. That's 222,100. Out of all the different combinations out there. So when you think about the rarity and scarcity, when mass adoption takes place, 222,100 of those will be numbers, combination and sequence of numbers via the normal way in the keycap way. That is pretty scarce to me, if I say so myself. So Ron scooping up those 5-digit keycaps, I believe that keycaps will have a play soon, because they are numbers. I made a post the other day. I said, you know, just kind of put a picture out there, in a picture of a 0 keycap with an equal sign with a normal 0, and then with a normal 0 with an equal sign with a 0 keycap. It's the same dang thing to me. I mean, as we start to move further into this, and I believe that Ron sees this, as things start to normalize more, these things will become the same. You'll be able to utilize them in the same exact way. What's going to be different is the aesthetics of them. The aesthetics will look different, but they'll be the same thing. And the ease of use and the easy way to remember a normal number will be the same way that you would remember a keycap number, because it's the same thing. So I think that we have to be careful about boxing in technology. I mean, tech advances every single day, every single day. And then you'll wind up kicking yourself in the butt when you start to look at the keycaps, and they're actually the same scarcity and the same use case as the numbers. So I think that's what we have to pay attention to and not overlook so much. But just want to go on that little rant and share that information. I appreciate Everybody tapping in today. I see my guy Bashara. What's up, Bashara, in here today? Yeah, but shout out to everybody. Thanks for tapping in. Continue to tap in, man. This is the type of discussions that we always like to have, and so that we can get a different perspective. You know, nobody knows the exact answer to everything. Nobody's a fortune teller in here. So sometimes you need the ability to bounce things off of one another and understand the perspectives that exist. So I appreciate you, 519. Thanks, man.
Yes, sir. Appreciate you, brother. Tap in with NFTverse, host of the ENS Friday Night Happy Hour. Giving out physical items if you hold the ticket to the NFT. So very exciting stuff there as well, brother. Cool. Let's go right over to my guy, 1261. The stage is yours, man.
GM, hope you guys are doing well. Just a short note for me today. Not much to discuss on my end, but I've been watching these the hearings around FTX and what's been going on. And it's really interesting when you see some speakers or some senators, they completely understand it. And then others are so completely misinformed about this industry, about Web3, about crypto, that it's almost laughable. And taking a step back, I've been thinking about, you know, why is it that way? And obviously there's some people are just genuinely misinformed. There's also part of it is, you know, playing to particular incentives. You may be, some of these people may be getting funded from particular sectors in the economy or companies and who have a vested interest in not seeing crypto succeed. But I think the main thing, it seems to me, is that just ignorance. I mean, even today, just had somebody who was speaking. She was an associate professor of law, and she gave her statement this morning, and she was talking about environmental issues regarding, you know, crypto, and as a whole range of different things that she mentioned, which were, to anybody who's in this space, you realize there's much more nuance to the conversation. There's much more nuance to the discussion. So to me, it's frustrating, but on another point, I think it's an opportunity for us as a community to really think about, how do we expand out of our bubble? How do we expand out of, you know, we're in this space right now, day to day. Kev has a great space for us, and we always were talking about these issues. We're talking about ENS. We're talking about the future. The future also is, you know, thinking about, we've got to think about, how do we bridge that gap between what's going on in the broader ecosystem, Web2, and also what we're doing here. Because I think this misinformation around these issues, it's really a big barrier to progress into mass adoption. I'm still absolutely bullish in terms of what we're doing here and where we're going. I think more and more I think about how do I communicate my passion, my energy, my enthusiasm for Web3, for ENS, in a way that's easily digestible to people who are in Web2. In a similar way, actually, funny enough, to how kind of ChatGPT has broken through, and, you know, I've had people who are using it who aren't really interested in tech usually. But again, it's not a fair comparison comparing AI and its growth compared to ENS. AI has been around since the 40s, or people have been working on AI since the 40s, and we're only about 15 years into crypto. So a big discrepancy there, but I think there's still the same principle applies around, how do we communicate what we're doing in this space and get it out to people who are in Web2, who have heard of, you know, FTX, they've heard of SBF, and that's what they think about of this space. We got to do more as a community. That's just my musing for the day. And then other than that, just excited to see how this week goes. Obviously, we've got the World Cup. That's going to be interesting to see how that goes. And also just keeping an eye on these registrations in terms of, you know, what names are being registered these days. It's always interesting to see what new strategies people are coming up with. So I know we had a couple of weeks ago a big push on AI, and I certainly was one of those people. But I think, you know, every day in this space is new. There's always something new going on. And I'm just, yeah, it's always interesting to keep an eye out those registrations. So have a good day, everybody. Good to see you all in this space. Thanks, Kev, for having me on.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Appreciate you, the professor, Mafiko. And I agree. I agree. I think with that story being covered with mainstream media, this is their first. And this is why crypto gets a bad rep sometimes, right? Imagine that being the first taste of crypto is seeing this big scam. When that's not crypto, kind of a master set. That's not the spirit of why this tech was created. But it is what it is. We got to continue to pave our way and do our thing. I'm going to go right over to OX Wizard. I mean, it's not OX Wizard, my bad. OX Tennis Bot. /OX Pickleball. The stage is yours, brother.
Yo, what's going on, fam? And you know, shout out to you guys on the bench here, hooking it up every day with ENS updates. And you know, just to piggyback on that, it kind of lead into what I had to say, because you know, AI, you know, we've been talking about it a little bit. I know it has nothing to do with, you know, ENS as much, but it kind of does, because it's just another tool to help us out, right? So literally, we had this morning at our show, the ENS Wake and Bake, we had a my AI team here stop by, and I was able to create, you know, content instantly. You know, I made a small video for him, but I was able to like come up with like tennis ideas off the back and just kind of made my life easier to make posts, to make content. And like I said, that frees me up to do more creative things on Web3, right? It gives me more time to kind of go about my day versus like, I need to find out the right wordage and verbiage on this. And it was great, man. And I can't wait to actually do this in large scale. So imagine if I was at the tennis courts, you know, helping these kids out, integrating them to Web3, opening their wallets and say, hey, you know what? I know you guys work hard here on the courts, but I know I see them all the time struggling with school. Because if you're a student athlete, you know, the study comes first. But, you know, these kids, they just want to play. They want to be on the courts. They can use AI to help their brains out, right? Give them small little rest. If they have no write an article or essay, they can use artificial intelligence to help them write that paper. You know, the small little tidbits that they can finish that easily. Focus on their main goal is to become the best tennis player in the world. So maybe if I provide that for the ENS community, it's just another tool to kind of help Web3 out. And I feel like, you know, we talk about it all the time here, but I think AI will become a more, you know, predominant thing here on the ENS updates for sure, guys.
I love that. That's was very, very well said, right? Help your life with the mundane tasks so you could focus on the things that actually matters. Definitely one use case for AI. I want to go over to our guy Bashar, nice having you back on the show, brother. How you doing, man?
How's it going, Kev? How's it going, everybody? We've been a little bit busy actually in real life the past few months, but you know, conviction is stronger and grows stronger by the day. What's up, Ron? I saw you earlier today snatching that lake house. I've been eyeing it for the past week. Lakehouse.eth, man, congrats on that. That's a great one. I've seen the space shifts, and I mean, into this weird snowball right now where we have that's my perspective as well. We have like gangs instead of one big community. And I definitely encourage all of you to, you know, get back to, you know, seeing the bigger picture here, where we're pushing the ENS to the next level, to the next adoption, in a good way, right? Yeah, I got into a debate this morning with somebody about crypto as a scam, blah, blah, blah. It was a funny debate, and in real life, by the way. And I ended up well. But anyway, yeah, it's funny to see if you recognize how early we are, all are, and it's very cliche to hear it, but it is. It is the reality, and we're going to get there. Just hanging tight. The liquidity will definitely flow. This is not hopium. This is reality, and we're in an extreme bear market right now. Enjoy it. And thanks for having me, Kev, and thank you for keeping up with this ENS updates. Kev, Ron, Master, NFTverse, and everybody on here. Appreciate it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Appreciate you, Bashar. If you guys didn't know, Me and Mashar go way back. He was actually who I started ENS Updates, the ENS Update show with way back in those early mid-April days and in those early May days of 2022. So appreciate you, Bashar. Much love, brother, and hope all is well. Let's go right over to our guy, Captain America, aka 6939. Dottie, stage is yours, brother.
And I'm so glad you added that second part, because good morning to all four-digit holders. Congrats on a nice bump overnight. It's always nice when there's a good digit run to kick off the day and remind us what we're all here for. I'm actually super annoyed that Bashara went up before me, because I was going to say what Bashara said. I was going to say, like, it's so easy to get caught up in all the BS and all this other crap in a bear. And, you know, he's talking about gangs and cliques and people getting divided and whatever. It's easy to get lost up in all that BS. This is like high school inside the Twitter metaverse sometimes. But when the ETH isn't flowing, you got to remember why we're here and what your why is and what you've been doing here. And to that note, we had some digits running. And this morning I hopped in the DMs of a up-and-coming Twitter influencer and made sure he got his dot ETH. So I didn't want to register it myself and sell it or whatever. I just alerted him that it was available, and he was appreciative and went and hopped over and is looking into the version of it that he wants. And that's what it comes back to. Those people will start looking more into the ENS communities, seeing digits, seeing clubs, seeing, you know, all the great things that we have to offer, spaces like ENS Updates, and little baby steps like that are how we continue to grow. So hope we all continue to grow as ENSers. Hope all digit people have a wonderful, beautiful Wednesday, a happy hump day. And thanks again, Kev, Ron, Master, everybody, for all you guys do. And last note, like I said, I hopped in here today right as Verz, and I hear Verz, you know, talk about a lot of different stuff in spaces, and what a beautiful little digit rant my man went on today. That is just absolutely gorgeous. So it's a good vibes for the digits today, good vibes for ENS. Hopefully today we can all begin to turn a new leaf and get back to the reason why we're here. Happy Wednesday, everybody.
Agreed. Appreciate the message. Captain America coming to save us all. Great message, right? I think it's easy to get bored in this space. And what I mean by get bored, where, you know, ETH isn't running, digits aren't pumping to 3 ETH. So the topics and the things to talk about in the community begin to shrink, and a lot of different things begin to arise as compared to digits blowing past 1 ETH, 2 ETH, 3 ETH, and what we hit 4 ETH is a whole different vibe and excitement. But if you are still here right now in this spaces, in this community, you're going to make it. And maybe a little bit of that is hopium, because maybe everybody won't make it. But what I do know is if you're actively here building, learning, grinding, learning by example, learning through mistakes, listening to those with more experience, not taking everything everybody else says, right, as law, but listening to others with experience, I think we're going to have a great time when the next bull run comes. Another thing I wanted to bring up, well, I'll bring that up a little bit later, but I'll go ahead and pass it over to our guy, Flossin, triple water gun, our triple pistol. Welcome, brother. All right. In the meantime, let's go right over to our guy, Enzo305. The stage is yours, brother.
What's going on, guys? Good morning. 5159, Ron, Master, NFTverse, everyone in the space. You guys continue to do it, you know, day in and day out. Add tremendous value to the community. And I just wanted to step up here and say a few things. You know, I was trying to explain to somebody last night, you know, what ENS domains really is, the technology behind it, sign in with Ethereum. And sometimes, you know, it's extremely hard, right? You don't know where to begin, how to start the conversation, how to explain it. And to touch back what NFTverse said when he was talking about keycaps and, you know, 4-digit keycaps, 5-digit. Well, once I passed through and explained, you know, normal digits and everything, how names and how metaverse.eth just sold recently for 99 Ethereum, it took me back to when I first had, you know, my flip phone than a BlackBerry phone, that was extremely hard to learn the technology around it and how to navigate through the phone, right? And I was one of those people that was stubborn about switching over to the iPhone when the iPhone came out, because I truly didn't understand, right? You're going from pressing buttons now to everything touch tone. And I know there's probably people here that are around my age, right, early 40s. And, you know, explaining how Ethereum, ENS domains work is similar, almost similar to explaining how phones, you know, work back in the day, right? It's extremely hard to for someone to want change and accept that. So when I started looking at keycaps, how undervalued they are relative to the regular four-digit community, I started thinking, what if one day, right, 5% of the world population is online, signing in with Ethereum, with the wallet? That's 400 million people, right? 10%, 800 million, that's just being modest. Even at 1%, you know, that's what, 8 billion people at 1%, right? 80 million, that's a lot of people. And not everyone will be able to afford 10K Club, right? 999 Club. At the time, if it's, you know, 100 Ethereum or what it is, the same way most people can't afford a Lamborghini, right? That's why we see a lot more Toyota Corollas or, you know, Chevys out on the road versus more expensive cars. So that's how I grasp the concept around it. And the reason why I think a lot of these different projects are extremely undervalued, right? If you look at, you know, at the Chinese digits, Japanese digits, and so forth. So I just wanted to touch on that. And, every day, you know, we're here. The ones that are here now most likely will make it. Not everyone will make it, right? But if you stick out every day and you truly believe in the technology and the way it will change the world, the only thing we can't change is time. We can't fast forward time and we can't go back in time. But we continue to show up every day, work, build together, you know, share ideas and thoughts and concerns, and we'll push through it, guys. I hope everyone's having a great day. Thanks again, Kev, for allowing me to say a few words. You guys are amazing. Have a good day, everyone.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. First is my laptop, and now my phone is acting up a little bit. But we're all good. We're all good. I thought this thing froze on me. Yeah, Enzo, appreciate you coming on and sharing those words. I agree 100%, right? Those numbers are coming. When those numbers will be here, I don't know. If I knew, I'll be a very wealthy man. I will tell you that much. If I knew, I would be a very wealthy man. But what I can tell you is I think we'll see massive acceleration within the next 12 to 36 months for the very reason that we're building meaningful dApps and platforms on top of these ENS domains that real life people will continue to use every day and find the utility and the usefulness in it. That's when mass adoption comes, in my opinion. So thank you for speaking on that, Enzo. I'm going to try flossing again, my triple pistol flossing. You there, brother? Yes, you are.
Yo, what's up, man? I was on a quick meeting, had to jump on a Zoom call, but I'm off now. My bad earlier. But yeah, man, we got that emoji space coming up tonight. Got a special guest, our first special guest, Penelope's Country Club. I'm honestly not too familiar with them. Our boy Evan15, the swimmer.eth, connected us. They do a lot of stuff with subdomains, do a lot of marketing, branding with emojis as well. A few days ago, they actually crossed over 1,000 subdomains issued to their community. So I definitely want to kind of ask them some questions about the subdomains, how that's working, where they see that going in the future, and maybe some other additional questions, right? Who knows who else might pop in? I know of another project that was telling me they might pop in as well. I might just DM them and save them for the following Wednesday. We'll see. A lot of good things happening, right? Ron touched on some keycaps and how they're being undervalued. I truly believe they are undervalued, as well as just standard digits as well, right? Seeing that little bump in floor price there, that's always looking good. But other than that, man, not much going on my end. Great space, right? Had a good, I think, ENS Latino space earlier today as well with John Cito and Wiz and Julio. It's just nice, you know, being able to link up with some good people in the community, and we're not going to let some of this midterm, I guess, drama or whatnot, you know, affect us. We're going to keep it moving. We're going to keep building, keep educating, and keep learning. So I appreciate you again, Kev, having me up, having this space day in and day out. And I look forward to, you know, coming to tomorrow's space as well.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Appreciate you, man. And I'll definitely stop by and tune in to the emoji space later tonight.
Hey, come up and speak this time, my guy. I mean, last time I called on you and you ghosted me.
Nah. I got you, bro. You know, that's around dinner time, and there's just a lot going on. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot going on around the evening. But I got you. I'll definitely tap in for a few on this space just to say what's up while I'm eating dinner or something. But I got you, brother. Let's go right over to Dope Mind. The stage is yours, bro.
Hello, everyone. I hope you can hear me. Great to be on the spaces back again, because, you know, I've been away for quite a while, but I've been around, like, just not being active on the spaces. I just wanted to say big respect and much love to everyone who's still involved, to you, Cal, for, you know, for running the show on daily basis, for to Master Ron, Bishara, NFTverse, everyone who's showing up, because the deeper we get into this period called bear market, you know, I'll just repeat after Bishara and a few others, and my conviction is growing, because I never stopped learning. From day number one, when I got into ENS, it was all about just getting as much knowledge as you know possible around this topic, both the positive sides and negative sides, the dangers of centralization, the way to decentralization, the true meaning, you know, behind what ENS can be, from this simple thing of connecting it to your wallet, changing the address to a cool name, rememberable name, then to using it. It's a, you know, whole different thing. When you start using it, it starts, you know, making sense. And if you believe in Web3, which is, in my opinion, if you are logically thinking human being, it's impossible to not really, you know, believe in Web3, because it's happening all around us and it's growing on a daily basis. And to be honest, we are already in deep in cyber economy all around. It's just not, the ties are not there yet, and it didn't click like to its fullest potential. But it's because the transmission is going on, and because of all this, you know, states making their moves. So nobody, some people don't want to be too fast into this before they don't have their systems ready. So, but today I wanted to say just a few words about how it, the bridge for people who are not into ENS, it can just be a matter of one discussion. I had a friend who came over from States a few days ago. He's a chef. He makes food for people. And he was offered by some students, because he lives near campus, payment in crypto. And he couldn't figure it out, how to work it out, how to make it possible. So he had to, you know, deny it for a while. So he asked me, man, how do I proceed? What is your advice? So I'm like, man, don't waste this opportunity. There's probably hundreds, if not thousands, of students around you who are already in crypto economy. They just deal with crypto, you know, and they're like, they probably switched already to this payments and to this, you know, to this system. So I set up a MetaMask for him, bought him, you know, a few domains, one that represents his business. I connected it to his wallet. So he saw that it's so simple. And I'm like, the next time, you know, you meet those guys, just give him this name. And, you know, when you get a transfer, it's going to be all set up. and then you can just prepare your food, you know, deliver it, and it's that simple. And he was so happy. And I know that it's his first move into, you know, crypto economy, and that's through ENS. So when things like that happen, I'm like, okay, I know why I'm here. I know what I get my knowledge for, because I can share it with people I like, you know, with people I trust and people who trust me. So I think it's a big deal. And to end up on a positive note, I don't know how many of you guys are familiar with a book called The Network State. I'm going through it right now, very interesting thing. And I'm starting to look at the communities in a little bit different way, because one of the principles of this book is the future startup societies that will could start online and first build online, then become legal states online, and then acquire some land in real world. And it makes a lot of sense to me. So I believe that some of the ENS communities could grow into future states and future countries or future cities. And I definitely see that happening. But before that happens, I think we have to move from like a flipping, profit-making mentality. And I think Master said that very well today, because the nature of blockchain, it wasn't made for that. It was made to make us stronger as communities and to build an alternative world to centralized fiat economy and centralized systems. So I'm into that position. If you haven't read it, it's a cool thing. It's online, and I truly believe that we have to focus more on building the power of communities, trusting our leaders, people like Cal, like Ron, like Master. I'll sign up if there was like a startup society started by these three gentlemen with one principle, because that's what this book, like, that's like one of the ways the author is sketching it up. He's like, don't put too much principles on your future startup society. Just put one thing, one main thing. Like, let's say our future country will be built on the principle of anti-canceling. We won't let people cancel other people. And that's one thing that we're going to build this society upon. So, you know, there's people here I trust. And I think that's one of the ways to move forward, thinking about building a future world, not really focusing that much on just getting money to transfer that money to fiat and get, you know, a nice car, because this is not, I think we're in a much more important part in our journey, which is a quest for future freedom. And that's how I see ENS as one of the bridges. Thank you, guys.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Much appreciated. Dope mind. I have not checked out that book. And I wouldn't mind building our own society either. You make it sound pretty interesting. I wouldn't mind that either, man. But appreciate you coming on. Dope mind. Love the name. 9396. You've been consistent. You've been here for a while, man. So that doesn't go unnoticed. It doesn't go unappreciated, right? Ladies and gentlemen, I have a very, very exciting announcement to make. Very, very exciting announcement to make. Was here earlier in the show, you know that my laptop was not working earlier. It turns out to be the outlet that I had it charged simply was a bad outlet. I plugged it in somewhere else, and this bad boy's up and running, and I'm in a way better mood than I was starting the show. Right, beginning of the show, I'm like, fuck, I gotta take this shit to the Apple store. I gotta spend this. Like, it was just the inconvenience of that blew me. But I'm happy. I'm back. This thing is working. I'm going to be sending your NFTs now in the DMs. I'm in the middle of that process right now as we speak. And I have a word from our sponsor. If you guys haven't already checked out vpn.eth.limo, please go ahead and check them out. There is a landing page built on top of vpn.eth that redirects towards options where you could register and sign up for your VPN. That is the basics of things that we're building in Web3 ecosystem, right? I want to give a huge shout out to ZZC Group. ZZC Group is an asset manager, management broker, and live auction house where we're going to be taking and pushing the boundaries and limits of what ENS is, right? We're going to be building some amazing platforms right now. We're working on, you guys might know, XXX.eth. We're working on, and that's all I'm going to say. That's all I'm going to say. We're working on XXX.eth. We're working on some other great things. We got to brainstorm. We got to put together. But let me tell you this. Let me say this one thing. When it's all said and done, I will be at peace knowing that we tried and we built something, right? And that's all we can do at this stage. But that's enough for me. I'm going to pass the microphone right over to Stephen Miller. The stage is yours, brother.
GM Kev, Ron Master, the rest of the ENS family, I feel tired. Because I partied my ass off yesterday and just want to thank every single person here for joining the ENS Shark Tank season finale. It was one hell of a way to go out. Ron absolutely crushed it. I heard nonstop good things from the community afterward. So big tip of the cap to you, sir. You brought the heat for sure and showed the teeth to the entire community. So big ups to you. And really, guys, like I just wanted to take that second to say thanks because getting the chance to host that show has been one of the like biggest pleasures of my years like so far. Obviously, we've got the holidays coming up, so I'm not going to guarantee anything that it's the top of the list. But yeah, man, it's been really fun. We've had a lot of highlights. Talked a little bit about those yesterday on the show, and we walked away really proud of what we did. So I've got a lot more that I have planned for it in the future. So if you did not yet tune in, I would love to see you come back and join us for season two early next year. I believe we're coming back January 17th. But throughout the break, I'm not going anywhere, guys. I'm still going to be here. Please know that, you know, I'm happy to join other spaces. I'm happy to help out anywhere you guys need me. And again, my heart's with the community. That's the reason I do what I do. So I'm happy to chat more with you later, Kev. I know I DM'd with you a little bit. If there's anything that I can do to be of help to you or anybody else through the break, please just give me a holler. But otherwise, we're going to keep on grinding, keep on doing it for the ENS fam, right? All right, guys, have a great rest of the day, and I'll see you in spaces later.
Yes, sir. Appreciate you, Steve. Appreciate you, brother. And shout out to a great season finale on the Shark Tank. Cool. Way to go out with Ron, man. Let's go over to Deva. I think that name is. I just brought Deva on stage. Deva, the stage is yours, brother. Deva, Diva, Troll, whatever you want to be called. The stage is yours. Okay, guess not. Well, with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, I do want to say one thing here before I get closing remarks and final words from everybody is in regards to the topic of the ENS DAO, the ENS Lab, Stewards, this has been a hot topic on the community. We had a great discussion on ENS Latino Space about this. And I want to say we are still in the infancy stages, literally, of the DAO, right? If this was a human, right, it's a baby. It's still an infant almost. It probably wouldn't even be able to walk or talk, right? So expect there to be a lot of things to be clearly that could be approved upon. And I expect things to be approved upon. And I expect things to be more transparent and more clear and more better functioning in the years to come. Right, not just in the weeks or months to come, in the years to come, because this is something that's going to take a while for us all to get used to. The idea and the concept of a DAO in itself is a brand new concept. Nobody was talking about, I'm not saying nobody, but that, how many people in this room even knew what a DAO was just 3 years ago? Right, just 2 years ago. Majority of us probably learned what it was between this year and last year. And maybe if you're super early, probably in 2020. So we have to, as humans, understand that, yes, we might personally feel some type of way, but it's always two sides to the story, right? And so let's have some empathy, let's have some sympathy, and let's take it upon ourselves to say, okay, we might not like the way some things are going, let's improve it together, right? Because I'm all for solutions and not just problems. Because we could talk about problems all day long. But if we're not talking about solutions, then what are we doing? So I just want to leave you guys with that in regards to the DAO and how, you know, whatever, all that mumbo jumbo over there. But that being said as well, any final words from our speakers, co-hosts, anybody before we call this one a day?
Yeah. Hey, Kev. Hey, it was great to see Bashara takes me back. So yeah, he was hosting with Kev and then I kind of joined him. And then Bashara got busy with IRL stuff and Mafiko, same thing. We all go way back in the historical NFT community where I met Kev and all these guys and NFT verse and stuff. So yeah, it's good to see them. And hey, it was great to hear from Enzo and Dope Mind. Some people we don't hear from every day. But it's good to hear because I mean, and encourage everyone to come up, even if it's not your first language, you know, and it's awesome that we have all these international spaces going on, but man, I'm telling you, it's a community. It's not about us up here talking every day. We share what we can, but I mean, you might have an idea that we've missed, right? None of us, no one can be everywhere at all times. So, Matt, come up and say hi and just network with the community. So I encourage a lot of that. And, when Master was speaking about going way back when they were buying it, they were spending a significant amount of money and it was very risky. I mean, our fund has been completely out of Ethereum two times in the last 5 years because we didn't know if they're going to get knocked out. Everywhere you turned around, there was Ethereum killer this, Ethereum killer that. Obviously, it was all bullshit. The dust settled, and there's only Ethereum for now. So it's way less, but it's still not guaranteed. We're still taking risks, but we're not only waiting for it. We're trying to build. We're trying to make stuff happen. Real excited what Kevin and some other people are working on to build those apps, putting the work in, because that's what we need to do. We need to get the word out. What we did in the early internet, we did anything we could to try and spread the word, and we were rejected, called scammers. I literally had the news come to my office and like run in, freak everyone out, and totally made us look on the local news, made us look like we were scammers with no, you know, just the idiots, right? Like Mafika was saying, people that should know better that don't even take an hour to sit down and understand stuff. But hey, that's neither here nor there. It doesn't matter. It's the way it's always been. It's the way it always will be. But yeah, I'm telling you, let's just keep grinding, keep being active in the community, keep doing whatever you can. That might just be retweeting and commenting and because, you know, when you guys retweet stuff, that's sometimes how we see it, right? We have this network, and sometimes I only see stuff because those of you in the community that I'm following and are following me retweet it. So don't think that everyone else is going to see it. Sometimes we won't. Everyone plays a part in this community, and appreciate everyone's work. And we're all going to look back and have some good memories, have that toast. I'll definitely have a toast. Kevin, somewhere I have a bottle of like 80-year-old whiskey or something that my dad bought, and I think it was like 40 years old, 50 years old at the time. And that was like 30 years ago. So I'm going to dust that bottle off and pull it out, and we'll bring that to the island, and I'll have a toast. So save that for a special occasion. But anyway, yeah, just, hey, look forward to the grind, and let's keep doing. Everyone doing their part. Everyone keep your head up, keep focused, and don't go crazy. Don't be FOMO, and don't be taking more risk than you should. You know, you got to be there. You got to be there at the finish line when we get there. So, you know, that's it. So anyway, everyone have a great wine or whiskey Wednesday, or what I think it's whiskey Wednesday on Garrett's show tonight. So anyway, everyone have a great day.
Whiskey, wine, bourbon, it doesn't matter. As long as you got something in your system and you're feeling good, that's what it's all about here. Any final words from anybody else? I just brought up Gig Attendees. Gig Attendees, did you want to say anything before we called the show a day?
Hey, yeah. So I'm actually 662.eth, but decided to go with this name from now on. But yeah, I just wanted to say, you know, with the market, you know, going as it is, you know, some people are down, some people are up. But let me assure you that there are hawks, you know, obviously not financial advice, but there are hawks watching the three digits, watching the four digits. And when it hits a certain point, people will buy. I know I'm buying if I see three digits, you know, go down any further. I know I'm buying, you know, a bunch of people are waiting to buy. So, you know, think long term. And, you know, if you like the project, buy it. If you don't buy it. But I know my faith has not waned or gone down or whatever. It's still the same. It's obviously an amazing project. And I just see the future for this, especially when you consider something like, you know, Other Side or whatever else. If one of these quote unquote metaverse actually take off and they support.eth and most people in the crypto ecosystem support.eth, I mean, just keep in mind, imagine owning like a rare number or something like that. That's just too epic of an opportunity to let go. So think long term, don't think short term, and keep your funds off exchanges. That's all.
Appreciate you, brother. And that just shows the importance of digital identities, right? I had no idea who you were, but when you said, "Oh, this is my name," I'm like, okay. So it'll be hard for me to get rid of 5159, just because you guys, this is how you guys identify as me, right? So it is what it is. With that being said, great episode today. I appreciate all the speakers. Gas is a little bit high right now, so I'm going to wait till it goes down a little bit, and then I'll finish out sending these NFTs that I got in my DMs. For some of you guys, I have already sent it to your wallet, so check your wallet. For others, if I haven't sent it to you already, please send me a message. It is a lot. There's been a lot of speakers on the show, and I want to get every single person, one of them. It's only going to be 200. And I think there's been about, if not more than 200 speakers on this show. So it is what it is. And I'm going to be doing some cool things with it in the year of 2023, which hopefully includes a private dinner on Ron's Island or something like that. But with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, have a phenomenal day. Check out vpn.eth.limo. They are our sponsors. They are what makes this show possible to happen as of right now, every single day. And this is ENS Updates. We'll be right back again here tomorrow at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And much love, blessings, and light to everybody in this community. 5159 is out. Peace.